So we are going to see the double block or the shoe brake. In the last lecture we have seen single block shoe brake, and in this single block shoe brake, if we look at the arrangement of this particular single block shoe brake, then we find that this particular shoe is being pressed against the wheel, and because of that there is a unbalanced force acting on the wheel. As there is an unbalanced normal force acting on the wheel, there are the chances of bending of the wheel shaft. So to overcome this difficulty, a double block or shoe brake is employed, and in this double block or shoe brake, two diametrically opposite shoes are employed on the wheels. Because of that, whenever these shoes will be pressed against the wheel, there will be no unbalanced force, or the two braking forces will counterbalance each other, and that's why we can eliminate the chances of bending of the wheel shaft. So this is a particular advantage of this type of double block shoe brake. If we look at the construction, so we are having a two diametrically opposite blocks or the shoes arranged on the periphery of the wheel to which the braking is need to be applied. These both the blocks or the shoes are being connected to the lever arrangement, and bell crank lever arrangement is used to actuate this particular block or shoe or the brakes. Now we are having a spring over here. This spring generally keep the shoes pressed against the wheel. Now this bell crank lever arrangement, when we push into the pull it into the downward direction, because of that this fulcrum will push the spring in, compress the spring, and these blocks or the shoes will move away from the wheel, and there will be no braking. So generally this type of arrangement, bell crank lever actuation of this bell crank lever is generally done electrically by applying the electrical and magnetic forces, and because of that this will be pulled in the downward direction. And in general working conditions, when this will be energized, bell crank lever is energized, there will be the no braking, there will be no contact of the block with the wheels. But whenever current is switched off, there is no force on the bell crank lever, and the brake is engaged automatically. That is, these shoes will be pressed against the wheel because of the spring forces, and due to this there will be no downward movement of the load. So such type of arrangement is generally used in electric cranes. So whenever there is accidental failure in the electric supply, then obviously this brakes will be applied automatically, and then the omission chances of accidents can be omitted. So in this double block brake, the braking action is double, as there are the two shoes or two blocks, we can say the braking action is doubled with the same force which will operate the one shoe. In this case of the double block or the shoe brake, the braking torque is given by TB is equal to FT1 plus FT2 into R, where FT2 is the tangential force exerted by the block 1 and FT2 is the tangential force exerted by block 2. So from this we can say the braking torque TB is actually double, because there is a two shoes where FT1 and FT2 are the braking forces on the two blocks. All other relations will be same as the single block or shoe brake. Now we will try to solve some numericals on this. A simple problem we are considering. A single brake as shown in figure. This is the figure. Single block brake we are considering. The diameter of the drum is 250 millimeter. The diameter is 250 millimeter, and the angle of contact is 90. Just observe the angle of contact, it is more than 60 degree. So obviously we have to use mu dash, that is effective coefficient of friction. If the operating force of 700 newton is applied at the end of the lever, 700 newton force, breaking force is applied, and the coefficient of friction between the drum and the lining is 0.35, determine the torque that may be transmitted by the brake. So braking torque we need to find out. So we'll just try to solve this. What is given, we will write down first. Okay, so given is diameter D, this is equal to 250 millimeter. Okay, as diameter D is 250 millimeter, we can say R is 125 millimeter, that is radius. Then 2 theta, that is angle of contact, is equal to 90 degree. If this angle of contact is 90 degree, then in radian we can say this is pi by 2 radian. And then the actuating force or the breaking force P is equal to 700 newton. And what is given? Mu, coefficient of friction, and that is 0.35. Now we have seen that is this angle of contact 2 theta is 90 degrees, so we can say as angle of contact is more than 60 degree, therefore we have to consider equivalent coefficient of friction. So equivalent coefficient of friction mu dash we know is given by 4 mu into sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine 2 theta. So this is equal to 4 into mu is 0.35 into sine. Now theta, 2 theta is 90, so sine theta is 45 divided by 2 theta. Now look over here, this 2 theta, theta we are considering in radian, that is 2 theta is nothing but pi by 2 plus sine 90, and this turns out to be 0.385, right? So let Rn is normal force pressing the block to the brake drum, right? And Ft is the tangential braking force. Ft is tangential braking force, and this we know, Ft is equal to mu dash into Rn. So taking moments about O for equilibrium, taking about O. So this is important. So about O, if we take the moment, that is we can say 700 multiplied by 250 plus 200, that is 450 plus, now Ft will assist, and Ft and the A is how much? 50 multiplied by 50 is equal to Rn multiplied by 200. So solving this we got, how you will solve it, this is equal to, we will put the value of Rn. We will put the value of Rn into this, and that is Rn is nothing but Ft by mu, as we know from this, that is 700 into 450 plus Ft into 50 is equal to Rn is Ft divided by mu dash into 200. So solving this, what we got, Ft, that is tangential force, is equal to 670 Newton, right? So if we got a tangential force, we know braking torque TB is equal to FT into R, and this turns out to be 670 multiplied by 125. R is 125, and this is equal to 83,750 Newton millimeter. So this is the braking torque, and this is the answer, we can say.